Here's what you talked about earlier. Can Dignitas take this chance and force the Baron?
So Cody can bullet time. I think he should do it soon.
He throws down the make it rain at first. Baron is down to 2,000 HP. This one could turn into a real close one. Kick into the pit coming through from Acadian. Someday's going into the pit now. A lot of damage going through, and Acadian is taken out. This Baron is anybody. It's a melee, and it's stolen by 100 Thieves. A critical error from Dignitas.
You take the fights where you can get them, and that fight fell into 100 Thieves.
Wow.
Bent that sword. Speaking of which, we just saw, another arrow.
We just saw that again, and pulled with the flash of the death sentence.
Yes, I got it.
Does that give enough time for Golden Guardian? Those turrets are gone, but now Conrad's here with home guards. This is maybe the play. Boom! Flashes in for the double play. FBI going to be beset here as well. This is going to be a lot of damage. However, he is taunted. He is forced away. The shutdown does come through. A 1-0, and this is going to be the second one as well. Who he does not have the way out.
As the waves come in, 100 Thieves have to find their way into the fight. Sitting and letting Immortals farm doesn't seem like the right way in. Shockwave catches three. That's the engage they wanted. Looking for the knockup, looking for the kill on the gate. This time they will again get him pulled back out, but he burns down all the same. Now so has the target. As the double kill comes through for Sunday, look to give him the third. It's going to go to Cody's son, and this has got to be the game.
He's looking for Poon or Ryoma, and then Cody's son's secondary target, but here comes the engage.
Here we go again. Double lift is the target. He's got no flash. He gets Walgreens up. Contracts takes him out, but the return damage. Absolutely absurd on TSM's side, but they can't get a carry just yet. Broken Blade gets hit. Here comes Sunday, but he gets exhausted. Very nice work there for Treats, but now Sunday begins the spins. Can he win? It's Treats that goes down as well after Speaker Falls and 100 Thieves Crumbs. They found the fight they needed. They will stay in this game as they pick up four.
They're a little tunneled in. So it definitely seems to be a few things plaguing Dignitas here. Right under the turret, they can see everyone. That is Phoenix's destiny on, and they're going to go for the engage as Boom comes back immediately with the quickness to stop up Dignitas. The retaliation is under toes. Glacial Fissure is going to miss on the Talakoti Sun, as now they have a chance to fire back some Mystic shots.
Game here so far. We'll see if they'll continue to build this lead. Nice interrupt there on the second part of the Resonating Strike. Meteos. There's where that ulti was. He was saving it for a rainy day, and it is pouring if you're Lee Sin. As more damage goes through, Kumo nearly taken out. That one's gonna be a one for one. Meteos explodes, double kill for Jizuke, but the fight is not over. Cody Sun's rotated in, and there we go. Sunday says, get back over there. He body slams them all.
He just needs to run at Ryoma, make sure he has to back up and can't clear that wave, and that's exactly what they are going to do.
Nice hook. Sunday going to get caught up, knocked up as well as he tries to dash away. That will spell doom, potentially, as the stasis is there. Flashes out, double loop. Face check in the Azir does not come recommended. Ryoma shuts it down. That's going to be another kill. Double there for Ryoma as TSM ran out of minions to tank the tower, and that was a bridge too far.
Ryoma got so much done there, and now here's Sunday.
Oh, goodness. Ragnarok popped, that speaker dead, Bjergsen and low as well. Shockwave is not enough to shut down the Sunday, but Sunday will take the shutdown.
They'll take two in hits here at least. But TSM, you have to think they want to stick around to end this game if they can.
Bjergsen looking for the shockwave, finds Cody! What a heroic move! Ryoma is still alive, but now he's finally going to be felled. Oh, I take it all back as somehow the shutdown comes in as Sunday, the only one left alive to defend the Nexus. Broken Blade and Bjergsen
have a ton of damage to super burn it down. They do have the Kennen and the Zaya, which helps to get those auto attacks in. Kabe low, like you said. Not too much for Ryoma to tag onto and get a distortion in there, and they might be able to take down Sunday. A nice Q, the heal back from Sunday. Gets himself a kill along with Ryoma. Can he keep himself alive? Sunday finally goes down to Broken Blade. There's another
Cody's
kill on the
other
side of the fight, and Cody's able to live on this one. Will he keep himself alive is the question. He stays down towards the bottom now. Meteos back into the fight. Rinse and repeat as the batting order comes back around. And Meteos is going to be in a dangerous pit of Baron, but it's not going to matter. Broken Blade goes down. As
he actually tried to go on Cody Sun, and Cody Sun was over by the red buff, so you had to know that he could have been there. Sunday getting very aggressive. The boom is on the flank.
Mash trying to get himself away, but Sunday is able to break down the hammer, and now Power of Evil is going to feel the power of Cody Sun. Look at the damage flying out through these spears, as Ignar should likely die here. The solo kill coming out from Sunday as well.
Ryoma's behind
the flash to go over the wall and chase him. Ryoma coming in from behind. There's your Syndra flank, Isaac. There's your plays from 100 Thieves. A double kill for Ryoma.
It's getting very, very...
Watch this. Just, oh, goodness. The Terra, it's just so stupid. He's going to chase down Vulcan.
Nowhere is
unstoppable. Good legendary. Doesn't get the kill on Sven yet. Niski flashing in Cloud9 trying to make a goal for Ryoma. He's in there. He's going to get cycloned up, though. There's the dunk from Blubber, but Cloud9 just don't have the money, the resources, the anything to finish it off. Something's charging in. Humping Thieves going to end the game right here as they're going to get absolutely everybody. Yeah, Cody, he's going to die again, but Conflex lives, and the Thieves are going to charge down mid to hound Cloud9 their first loss of the summer.
Ryoma, that's not a good spot to be. Does get unleashed on again. Ulti out of Gragas. Does dodge the Brawlmort with the stasis. Good planting there from Thresh. Oh, goodness, hello! Expendi out of nowhere will go down. A little too far as Meteos finally going to get some revenge.
Santorin trying to step up here, throw some axes into the brush to clear the
Power
of Evil is about to get killed in three auto attacks from Sunday, but the CC shows up. Power of Evil still kept alive for a moment, but Cody Sun's going on a rampage. Sunday's at 25%, but he is still trucking. Using the hammer to knock Solo away, trying to get himself out, but he will be shut down. Solo stands alone in the middle of four, and Cody Sun has a triple kill.
If 100 Thieves committed too far forward, so he's actually going to commit the Lightning Rush. He's trying to get around behind.
Coming through the pit, Dragon's aggroed onto him, but he should be able to get through. Just a QW to start things off. His bullet time is basically missed. What a kill coming in from Ryoma. Absolute deletion on Broken Blade. He did not expect that, and now TSM has to figure out how to assess this fight correctly. 100 Thieves looks to re-engage one more time. Dardock going low as he safeguards back to Bjergsen, and the rest of TSM is going to get himself the safety, but it does not look like they are out of the woods just yet. Someday coming out of the woodwork, and he's going to get a few more for himself.
There
Ryoma picks up kill number two. That's a kill coming in for Cody Sun, and now
so the wall, if he can hit it with his spear, it gives him much more chance. That's going to be going over to Someday. Oh my god, 100 Thieves get it. They're going to be going through this fight hard. They have to get themselves some distance so they can get out of Cody Sun's kite. Here's Bang, starts to fire back. Who's going to be getting it? It's just the headshots. Cody Sun's Infinity.
Because of good cooldown tracking on summoners, and now we might see something a bit more here. Ryoma, he'll put a taunt, but Vlad is going to dive in. It's TP Central here in mid lane, and boom, he's going to be the first one locked up at the Ragnarok. There, he's going to get trapped as he tries to run in, but Sunday also blasting in there as Liquid will be slain. Blabber will be killed by Sunday, and the Thieves, they're going to get more. Ryoma with a max range Justice Punch finds the third onto Vulcan.
There's enough backup from the team, and now Sunday's back to mid lane. Aka cannot find that kill, but Apollo sure can. And that's another pickup, though. Ryoma gets revenge for his support, and yet again, mid lane is pushed away.
Whoa.
What a play! Ryoma over the wall finds a double kill.
Next weekend, another Sun's going to land. Spence Garen, another health bar running low, but penalty and lives. It's now Bang's turn to flash away. I think I've seen this before. Underneath that turret. Deja vu.
We got a replay from the future. I was wondering where it came
okay,
from.
Okay, yeah, I was so confused. I was like, did I just, like, miss everything?
So I was like, maybe, like, the game is going so fast that we haven't caught up with this. Like, but it was just a little divination from the future here. 100 Thieves showing that they can pull off the heist underneath the turrets from EG. You already know how it is.
Two-item ballistic try to kill frontline. Going to be hard to do that one. They knock down some wards, look for the re-engage. Gold Blue has package, gonna go for the play here with Shen over the top. We wanted to see these plays. Shen blocks the knockup, Ryoma burns Azonius. Here, how about the re-engage? Easy first kill, yes, it's on the board. EG, 5v4, can you somehow make it work? Someday is about to find the flank. He's coming up nearby, Cody Sun's low. Here comes Camille over the top, but Cody Sun's on one hit, and Hoonie is fighting contract. Big damage to the front side. Someday burns the stop. Watch Cody Sun's on the board. Spence Garrett is low. Cody Sun flashes and gets the double kill. Zazel gets the flay. He's trying to stay alive. He won't do it. And the final kills will come through. Goodbye to the rest of you. A dad is Penguin. And 100 Thieves have knocked down the ace.
Carious stunt. Finds the hook on a double if he cleanses out. Boxes up. They're going to have to get out, but I don't think they can. Someday's in the pit. They need to finish off the objective. Something is going to have to happen here. They'll take down Olaf, though. That's a good call. But now the Baron should be there. Speaker. He's not going to finish off. Are you kidding me? Ryoma somehow steals it away. And now Someday's on the chase. Ryoma's still going alongside his AD as Cody is still peppering arrows in. And TSM, they're about to get completely cut off here by 100 Thieves. I just don't think they can win this fight. Firefox finds the hook, gets stumped, but that's not the one that needs the kill. That's two down already as Ryoma is continuing to rampage in this team fight. He's finding everything. Gherkin gonna get shot back. That's the kill. That's the Bud Light Ace as TSM will fall. And that may be the game handed over on a silver platter.
Get both off the extended range and do about one third of someone's health.
Doublelift doing a lot of poke. Shockwave on two. Is it enough? Ult comes in. Four gonna save Doublelift. The stopwatch to re-engage the ult at the top as well. Is it enough? Cody Sun brings his own stopwatch into the back lane. Goes Sunday. He gets one. He's gonna get two. He's looking for number three. Doublelift tries to make the big play. The kill after kill after kill. Picks up the Quadra, and 100 Thieves will knock down Team Liquid.
I just killed everyone.
Hard engage on their side, right? You mentioned already, Olaf behind, building Warrior Cleaver damage build, even with a Yumi on him, is not scary enough. It's not a great hard engage. And
Meteor there finds the ulti. Golden Glue, they're knocked up by the Nautilus Sword at the same time. Means that chain didn't quite connect the way they wanted. Hook almost takes down Golden Glue, but maybe the main event is happening in the bottom left of your screen, as Sumnay is just solo winning the game on Lucian.
The map pressure and Meteor shown bottom lane. This is just Rift top lane. They're gonna try and kill the play before dropping Rift, or maybe just kill Sunday.
Looks like the dive could be the choice here. Ulti coming out from the Kale onto Wiggly. He wants to dive through, find the execution onto Sunday. But this is how Sam outplayed. You do not respect the Haymaker.
Oh man,
you get smacked. Stunt dropping a ward over the wall to keep an eye on this Elder Drake. Meteos is also still hanging around. He knows if nothing else, you've got to try to go in and steal this if the Golden Guardians are making the call to start it up. Golden Glue looking for the damage here once more, trying to find us a little bit more. Meteos goes Golden, but he's at 100 HP. This is so dangerous for 100 Thieves. Golden Glue's hanging around now still as well. We'll see where the Elder Drake's gonna go. 100 Thieves still looking to make the fight. Closer is shut down. This fight is not available. Meteos is available. And the Elder Dragon for 100 Thieves. Fire your laser.
Oh my god, they get the kill on the jungler, and then Meteos comes all the way back on Gragas, flashes into the bit, and secures the Elder Dragon.